Portions of News Service 18 are...
Questions persist over railroad relocation.
Sponsored by Bob Roman Auto Sales and by Lafayette Bank and Trust. This is News Service 18 with Kent Schmidt, Mary Meislewick, Jim Stage Weather, and Larry Quisby Sports, the late edition.
Good evening. Looking at the impact of a gubernatorial debate.
Plus, funding for the railroad relocation project seems to be in limbo.
Officials of the Lafayette Railroad Relocation Office are confident failure to include funding for their project in Senate legislation does not spell the end of the venture. Project Director Dan Fogarty says the panel in which Congressman John Meyer serves as ranking Republican member and included $7.8 million may come to bear on Senate conferees.
It's absolutely very, very crucial that we get funding so we can start construction, but it's not down to the extent that we don't still have a shot at it. We certainly do, and we are very solidly in the House version of the bill, and we certainly need to focus on the conference committee and see that we get some consideration there.
Fogarty says mere Senate authorization without appropriation dollars to get the work done would be meaningless.
Democratic gubernatorial candidate Wayne Townsend is still pressing Governor Robert Orr for a series of debates. Orr agreed last week to one debate, but Townsend says he's not happy with just that. The face-off has been set for September 9th in Indianapolis. Purdue political science professor Robert Browning says place has a lot to do with the impact of a debate.
Bring the candidate out to five different locations in the state. That brings much more visibility to that local area. The candidates are there. The local press has an opportunity to talk with them, to write about the stories, to have the people on the air, to comment upon it. People in the community get a chance to go to the debate. So there's much more visibility, and it brings the campaign down to a level, to a community level, where more people can see it, where it's not removed as one time in the Indianapolis that occurs on Friday night that many people miss.
Townsend says he'll continue to press for more meetings between he and Orr. In politics nationally, Walter Mondale brainstormed today with several of his top aides on an acceptance speech to be delivered next week. This will follow Mondale's anticipated nomination for president at the Democratic National Convention. A campaign spokesman says Mondale is also, in his words, thinking about who his vice president will be. The spokesman indicated no meetings with prospective VPs are scheduled this week. So far, Mondale has interviewed seven people in his vice presidential search.
President Reagan says he doesn't think Jesse Jackson broke the law when he went to Syria and Cuba to negotiate the release of prisoners. But when addressing a group of visiting journalists, Reagan said it would be very dangerous if this became a political ploy for candidates in the future. Last week, Reagan indicated Jackson may have broken a law which prohibits private citizens from representing the United States while dealing with other countries. Reagan said he's grateful to Jackson for doing something he couldn't have done officially, but added in his words, he could have done without some of the criticisms of American policy which were made while Jackson was in the two countries. A Middle East Airlines plane carrying 108 passengers from Saudi Arabia made a bit of history today. It was the first commercial flight into Beirut since Lebanon's civil war shut down the airport 5 months ago. The travelers needed an escort of troops because angry Muslim demonstrators are trying to block airport roads with burning tires. They're protesting because they have as yet no word on the fate of thousands of relatives kidnapped during the civil conflict.
Presidential advisor Martin Feldstein is returning to Harvard after a two-year leave of absence spent at the White House. Feldstein's past criticism of the way Reagan was handling the economy led administration aides to pass the word that he was not a team player. Today, Feldstein said his problems were, in his words, not with the president, but with some of the people in the administration. Feldstein says he gives Reagan, in his words, a very, very high grade. In the past, he has insisted that big deficits are a primary reason for high interest rates. He advocates tax increases as a way to keep deficits down.
With the LA Olympics this month and with record inventory levels, we at Bob Roman, Lincoln Mercury, and Subaru decided to have an Olympic sell down.
Save on gold, silver, and bronze medal deals such as this gold medal value 1984 Mercury Lynx, $58.18 delivered. and this silver medal deal, 1984 Mark 7 or Continental, at dealer invoice. Plus this bronze medal deal, 1984 Subaru hatchback, only $59.99 delivered. So go for the gold this month at Bob Roman Lincoln Mercury and Subaru.
Add a little of this, add a little of that. At Wendy's Garden Spot, you know that's up to something beautiful.
At Wendy's Garden Spot, you can make hundreds of deliciously different salads, and each adds up to less than 300 calories. Spots something better for Wendy's kind of people.
Interest rates are high, but not at Carpetland. Because today, Carpetland is offering free credit on any carpet purchase over $300. That's right. You make 12 monthly payments on the carpet of your choice, and Carpetland pays all the finance charges. The price of many sale carpets even includes pad and installation. 12 monthly payments on the carpet of your choice with no finance charge. Don't miss this incredible Carpetland deal.
Carpetland USA. Carpetland USA.
A Department of Education spokesman says it looks like most Indiana schools will implement Project Prime Time next year. The program will reduce grade one class sizes. One Indiana school corporation is going about the reduction in an unusual way. Lebanon Community School says busing students from an overcrowded elementary school to an undercapacity one 8 miles away. A different way of reducing class sizes.
Yes, it is, Mary. And also, Project Prime Time requirements are causing other school districts to look at things in a different way and reorganize and looking into the possibility of hiring teachers. Some educators have stated the Project Prime Time program is a product of political necessity in Governor Robert Orr's election year and is not spawned from a concern over improving the quality of education in the Hoosier State. But News Service 18's Jim Stage reports two area educators are pleased with the program. Tippecanoe School Corporation Superintendent Dr. Ken Coger says the idea is a good one.
I think the potential for the idea, Jim, is good. One might debate whether 18 is the proper magic number or whether it could have been 20 or 21. But aside from that sort of debate, the general idea of offering smaller class sizes to the very early grades, the primary grades, certainly is a worthwhile thing to do, and for the state of Indiana, very innovative.
A longtime local elementary school principal in West Lafayette feels his school district has always been a vanguard of excellent student-to-teacher ratios. Cumberland Elementary Principal John Peretti says the new guidelines will ensure the state is moving in the right direction in regards to upgrading education in its elementary schools.
I believe that more benefit will come to the children with the lower class ratio. I think teachers, especially in the lower grades, can do more and give more help if the classes are smaller. I liken it to an apprentice with a master craftsman. He can work with an apprentice. It's very difficult to work with 20, 30 apprentices and get more done. And I think it'll be a benefit.
The West Lafayette and Tippecanoe School Corporations will both discuss primetime requirements at their Wednesday night meetings this week.
Indiana Governor Robert Orr says the newly organized State Board of Education represents a milestone in the state's efforts to improve education. Orr today named four new members to the board. Robert Haney of Monticello is among them. They joined six people who belong to the old Commission on General Education. Governor Orr says the 1984 legislature's decision to restructure the board should lead to better leadership for Indiana schools. Well, a move has been made by Purdue University officials to improve communications with deaf students. A new faculty position has been created and filled with the appointment of Myron Yoder of Goshen. His official title will be sign language instructor and interpreter for deaf students. Yoder's appointment represents a milestone for the school, according to Purdue officials. Much of Yoder's time will be spent in classrooms interpreting. There are only a few deaf students at Purdue.
Indiana college professors aren't making as much as some of their Midwestern counterparts on the average. A National Center for Education Statistics study shows Indiana professors rank sixth among seven states surveyed. Professors in the Hoosier State earn an average of $29,646 for women and $33,566 for men. Illinois male academics pull in an average of $35,654. Their female counterparts make $30,572. Still ahead on the late edition, Mary, an Indiana Legislative Study Committee considered the creation of a statewide cancer information center for the Hoosier State.
Plus, Kent, a new over-the-counter drug is causing some concerns in the medical industry. Stay with us.
Now you can earn high certificate of deposit interest and qualify for great gifts at Bank and Trust. Choose from 250 name brand gifts, such as Nikon cameras, GE video recorders, Jacobson riding lawn tractors, or TVs, luggage, appliances, and much more. Great rates, great gifts. Yours for a limited time only at Bank and Trust.
And certain trust at Bank and Trust. Lafayette Bank and Trust. Lafayette Bank and Trust.
Hills is the place for kids.
Check us out.
You may have heard that Hills has one of the biggest selections of girls' dresses in more styles at low prices every day than just about anyone. But have you seen them? And at Hills, you can lay away up to five girls' dresses with just a dollar down. Can you name another store that can do that?
Hills, the place for kids.
Check us out.
Subaru Gold Rush Days, a bonanza of incredible values on all 1984 Subaru cars, including models with on-demand four-wheel drive. Better hurry. With these great values, the rush is on. Subaru Gold Rush Days.
Make your claim at your Subaru dealer today.
Bob Roman, Subaru, Lafayette.
Portions of News Service 18 are sponsored by Lafayette Pool and Patio and by Mr. Steve's Rentals. 12 locations in north central Indiana.
The creation of a statewide cancer information center in Indiana is being considered by a legislative study committee. The center would compile data about the number of people who acquire the disease and whether they live in areas of higher than average cancer incidence. A Board of Health spokesman says better reporting of cancer could lead to ultimate prevention. He says one of four Hoosiers will develop cancer in their lifetime.
Some Indiana and Illinois pharmacists are being asked to store a non-prescription pain reliever behind their counters so they can screen customers before selling it. The drug is ibuprofen, or known under trade name as Advil or Nuprin.
In years past, ibuprofen in prescription form was used as an anti-inflammatory drug for arthritis patients. An FDA advisory panel on pain and pain relief found that the drug at low dose levels could be used safely and effectively for premenstrual syndrome, so the drug was marketed for over-the-counter use under the names Advil and Nuprin. But if taken incorrectly, the drug could produce some adverse effects, and that's the reason there's a call to bring the drug behind the pharmacist's counter. Dr. Nick Popovich thinks the action is a very good idea.
Because the thing that people should realize is that over-the-counter drug products are not always safe and they're not always effective, depending on the type of drug. And I think what the pharmacists were trying to do in Illinois is to prevent any problems with the drug.
What problems could arise from taking ibuprofen?
Well, the problem that they're worried about, like with ibuprofen, is that the drug is eliminated. It's gotten rid of by the body through the kidneys. And so you have to be very careful of the patient's kidney status to make sure that the patient can handle it, that she does have good kidney function. Now, with the kidneys, for instance, the problem that could come up with antihypertensive medication or high blood pressure medication would be that the ibuprofen would interfere with the effect of the antihypertensive or high blood pressure drugs. So then there would be an interaction conflicting, and so the person's blood pressure would go up, you see, and so that's basically what they're concerned about.
Popovich says by having the pharmacist screen the customer, they can be sure the customer is a candidate for Advil, and any complications from the drug could be prevented.
Popovich says that even though you can get a variety of drugs over the counter for many different ailments, it doesn't mean that the drugs are safe for you.
And Mary, a study by the National Institutes of Health has been launched to determine the benefits and risks of using drugs to treat elderly victims of high blood pressure. More than 5,000 senior citizens around the country are being studied. Jerry Sander has this report from Lexington, Kentucky.
Systolic high blood pressure is not uncommon among those 60 and older. Its cause can usually be traced to arteriosclerosis, or hardening of the arteries. Because of the risk of heart attack or stroke, older patients are often put on drug therapy. But do the pills reduce that risk?
remember the last time you had your blood pressure measured?
Kentucky researchers will follow 200 to 300 people over the next 5 years, paying particular attention to the upper or systolic number in the blood pressure reading. Some of the volunteers will receive a diuretic commonly used to treat hypertension. Others will be given sugar pills, placebos. The idea is to see whether medication is the best course of treatment.
And intuitively, it seems reasonable to assume that if you lower the blood pressure, you will lower the risk. There are side effects, but they are probably relatively minor. Intuitively, clinical judgment for many people says, yes, let's treat with a drug. But scientifically, we don't have the fact.
The study will also explore possible negative effects of long-term drug therapy on the elderly suffering from isolated systolic hypertension. Jerry Sander for CBS News, Lexington, Kentucky.
The rate of increase of medical costs is down by almost one half since President Reagan took office. That's according to Health Secretary Margaret Heckler. According to Heckler, medical inflation was 10.8% a year when Reagan became president, compared with 6.3% for the first 5 months of this year. She says the cost of one day in the hospital is now going up 9% a year. Well, that isn't the only thing that's going up. The temperature seems to be going up, as the humidity.
High temperatures and high humidity tomorrow will put us in a danger index for health around the area because of those very hot conditions.
You probably thought about owning your very own pool at one time or another. Owning your own pool lets you literally open your back door on a whole new way of life. You can own your very own Fox swimming pool just like this one with one call to Bob and Mary Graham of Lafayette Pool and Patio. In most cases, Lafayette Pool and Patio can install a beautiful Fox pool of your dreams within a week. Discover the possibilities. It really is affordable. Find out more at Lafayette Pool and Patio, 188 Ferriby Drive in Lafayette.
The promise of Earth Grains.
Earth Grains, the promise of bread at its best.
The promise of whole wheat, wholesome and good. Of sourdough English muffins, incredibly delicious. Of hearty rye, rich in texture. The promise of Earth Grains is natural goodness. Goodness captured in over 30 varieties of bread, baked with pride and bursting with fresh baked aroma. Earth Grains, proud to be served to the athletes at the 1984 Olympics.
Get a Noble Roman's Monster Pitcher for just $2.99. Then, the next time you order any large pizza, bring your pitcher back. And we'll fill it with Coke, absolutely free.
Hot temperatures across the Hoosier State today. High temperature in Lafayette area of 94 degrees. Overnight low of 63 left us three above the norms of 87 and 64. The record for this date, 103 degrees, set in 1936 for the all-time high, low of 46 in 1963. Currently 84 degrees in Lafayette. The humidity is up to 80%. Southerly winds of 9 miles an hour. The barometer at this point in time is rising. From this afternoon, we can take a look at the cloud cover on our weather map, where you can see that there's a certain area of cloudiness now moving. Okay, there we go. Slight risk of cloudiness. And there you go. The cloud system moving across the northern part of the state. You can see it's not a very well-organized system, and out in the west, another frontal system is building up, which will begin to bring more wet weather to our area later in the week. This sort of frontal system in through here is a very weak cold front that will be moving through the state sometime along about Wednesday. That'll provide us with cooler temperatures, at least for a couple of days, but it'll still remain very hot throughout the week compared to the wonderful weather we have been having. So you can see here this high-pressure system is keeping things very, very clear across the entire state. That will keep the sun blazing throughout the rest of the week, and humidity is very high as well, as warm, moist air starts to rise up from the Gulf of Mexico because of that high-pressure system and the flow of air around it in a clockwise direction. Overnight, temperatures will only dip down into the upper 70s across the entire Hoosier State, and by tomorrow, into the 90s, and we might even reach triple digits across some parts of south-central Indiana by tomorrow afternoon. St. Louis, Missouri hit 100. Reason why, jet stream being pulled up by that low-pressure system, allowing that warm, moist air right to flow into our region. And that will keep things uncomfortably hot over the next five-day period, some 4 to 8 degrees above what we usually expect at this time of year for the normal temperature period, so things will remain hot and stay there for several days. State map shows us what's going on at newscast time. Up in Gary, 85 degrees. and then down to 86 in Evansville. So you can see a fairly even range of temperatures across the entire Hoosier State. Will keep things warm throughout the evening hours as well. We're only expected to slip down in the 70s overnight. Here's a look at some temperatures across mid-north Indiana at newscast time. 80 degrees in Monticello, a little bit cooler up there by the lakes, and 86 in Kokomo, where that is the warmest temperature recorded at newscast time. Forecast for tonight is expecting a low temperature of about 73 degrees under fair skies. Very, very warm southwesterly winds. Tomorrow, we're expecting those southwesterly winds to continue to pump hot, humid air into mid-north Indiana. Partly sunny skies, extremely hot and humid, high of 96 degrees. And as we said, it may even drift a little bit higher than that. Tomorrow night, partly cloudy, 20% chance of thundershowers, low of 73. Wednesday, partly sunny, slight chance of thundershowers again because of all the heat and humidity, high of 90. That's a look at the weather, not a very cheerful one at that. The main thing to keep in mind is to be very, very careful when wandering around outside tomorrow, because that heat and high humidity, when you're not used to it, can be very, very dangerous.
Yeah, the hot weather on the tails of a nice cool weekend.
That's right.
Thanks a lot, Jim. Tippecanoe County's jobless rate dipped 0.2% from April to May. That's according to figures released today by the Indiana Employment Security Division. The seasonably adjusted May rate of 5.9% is down from April's rate of 6.1%. The Indiana jobless rate also fell 0.3% to a May level of 7.5%. Small businesses and budding entrepreneurs will have an opportunity to meet with investors at an Indianapolis conference this September. Lieutenant Governor John Mutt says the Indiana Institute for New Business Ventures will sponsor the Entrepreneurial Capital Conference September 25th and 26th. Mutt says about 60 investors are expected to attend the conference.
Brokers are holding out in hopes that today's strong advance for Wall Street may signal the beginning of the traditional summer rally. The market dropped lower for most of the day until a sudden buying spree through blue chip and auto issues lifted prices higher. The Dow Jones Industrials gained 11.48 to 1134.05 on moderately active trade of 74.8 million shares. Declines edged advances by only 15 issues. Time now for Larry Clisby with his sports report for the night.
And for you people and for you out there, a history-making night at the Hoosier Dome in Indianapolis. And we'll give you details on that, plus plenty of other sports news, so stick with us here.
Mr. Steve's Rentals invite you to compare rental stores. Rental rates, rental policy. There's a difference in rental stores, and we're rental specialists. It's all we do. Mr. Steve's Rentals offers you the widest selection of new brand name furniture, appliances, color TVs, and stereos. And our 33-store volume buying reduces our costs, saving you money on lower rental rates. Regardless of your credits, you can rent to own at Mr. Steve's Rentals of Indiana, now with 12 stores in Hoosierland.
I'm Bob Basney, announcing no-nonsense 84 closeout prices. 500 cars and trucks must be sold, so every new 84 is marked with a no-nonsense discount. Like these Escorts, the world's number one seller. $58.88 or $117 per month, here's Tempo. It outsells the imports. $69.99 or $129 per month, hurry to Basney Ford in Lafayette and buy at no-nonsense delivered prices marked on all new 84s, and that's a fact.
If you bought your TV 2 years ago, it's probably out of warranty. Just in time for the Olympics, unless you bought a Curtis Mathis with their exclusive 4-year limited warranty. And right now, get up to a $100 rebate on Curtis Mathis console and big screen TVs. Up to a $100 rebate.
Curtis Mathis, a little more expensive, but worth it.
Don't miss out. Get up to $100 rebates on Curtis Mathis consoles and big screens now.
And good evening, everyone. A history-making evening tonight in the Hoosier State is the largest crowd ever to watch a college basketball game in person. More than 67,000 jammed the new Hoosier Dome to watch Bob Knight's Olympians take on a group of NBA All-Stars. It was the fifth game for the Olympic All-Star team during its exhibition season prior to the summer games. Don't have much video to show you tonight, but we do have just a tiny, tiny bit. This is a sequence in the first half at halftime, and now moving into the second half, the Olympians led by a score of 50-40. You have a chance here in just a moment to see the coaches involved in tonight's game. There's Coach Bob Knight. I got a thunderous ovation when he was introduced at a very long pregame ceremony that took, I'd say anywhere from 20 to 40 minutes. Kevin Lockery, the coach of the Chicago Bulls, and he is, of course, coaching the NBA All-Star group. 50-40 at the halftime. By the way, Purdue's Gene Katie was named the honorary coach and was introduced tonight. He didn't get the same ovation that some of the others got. For example, like Larry Bird, who really brought the house down, and of course, Steve Alford, the Olympian from IU, and Quinn Buckner playing for the NBA Stars, a former IU player. But quite a night down there. And by the way, our Paul Stoddard is down there, and he'll be coming back tomorrow, and we'll have a complete wrap-up of tonight's activity, and again, a history-making night indeed. Also, I do want to tell you that there was a girls' game on. Cheryl Miller of Southern Cal scored 15 of her game-high 18 points to lead the U.S. Olympian women's team to a 97-54 rout in the first game of that doubleheader tonight. Well, Gene Katie has added another recruit to his 1985 class after Tony Patterson of L&M High School declared today that he'll attend Purdue starting in the fall of 1985. This is the second player that has declared early for the Boilermakers, the other Kip Jones of Belmont, Indiana. You have a chance to take a look at Tony there. He's 6'5" tall. He averaged 24 points a ball game last year for L&M, a team that was ranked 10th in the state and caused quite a stir down south because they have only 130 boys in their school, and they had a record of 23-1. But he hopes to play either guard or forward. He probably will be playing at the big guard for the Boilermakers. A good look at a new Purdue recruit, Tony Patterson. Well, the 55th annual All-Star Baseball Classic will take place tomorrow night in San Francisco. The starting pitchers were announced today, and it will be Dave Steeb of the Toronto Blue Jays hurling for the American League, while Charlie Lee will get the nod for the Nationals. Lee pitches for the Montreal Expos. Although the National League has dominated for almost 20 years, as all you baseball fans know, the American League will try to make it two in a row. The AL won it last season, 13-3, with Steeb coming away as the winning pitcher in that game. The only Chicago representative starting in the contest will be Cubs second baseman Ryan Sandberg. Well, over the weekend, the United States Football League had their semifinal playoffs, and I realize with the Wimbledon Tennis Championships going on and plenty of All-Star baseball approaching the All-Star game and plenty of great games, you probably didn't even notice who won, but the Arizona Wranglers right there won on Saturday night as they won for their coach George Allen and moved into the final game. That's quite a surprise coming out of the Western Division. And meanwhile, the Philadelphia Stars, seen right here, ran by, thanks in part to Kelvin Bryant, who scores right here, to beat the, the Birmingham Stallions. That's correct. Even I had forgotten who was playing. 20-10 was the final score in that contest, as we see a fumble there recovered in the end zone and taken in by the Philadelphia Stars on this wild play right here. So those two teams will be playing in the championship game. I know we're all excited about it. Sometimes people get, oh, there's one other thing I got to mention. I want to make sure I get this on the air. I had 16 calls on this, and this is a softball score. Fashions Plus in women's softball, 17, General Food, 7. The reason they thought it was so important to get it on, they told me that it was only their third win of the year. Wow. And I said that I would make an exception tonight for that. Oh. By the way, I'll wear the bag if the American League doesn't win the All-Star game. How about that?
Hey, okay, I'm ready. Lady.
We'll be right back. We've only been in the Lafayette area for 5 years, sold over 10,000 cars, and become Indiana's largest combination Pontiac Datsun dealer. We're grateful to our customers and will continue serving them with new Pontiacs and Datsuns. Service is now and will remain a number one priority. Our used car world is quickly becoming the number one place to buy a used car or truck in Lafayette. We want to sell everyone in Tippecanoe County a car. We will keep trying. That's a promise from me, John Shaver.
Come to John Shaver Pontiac Datsun's 5th anniversary sale, now in progress.
One of the things that attracted me to the Bluffs was the price. As a new graduate student at Purdue, I'm on a very tight budget. Another thing that I liked about the Bluffs was the fact that I got to pick out my own wallpaper, my own carpeting, and my own paint color.
Terry and I moved here from Tucson, and we looked all over for a place with great atmosphere and really nice people, and we found it here at the Bluffs.
And I can walk right outside the door and jog with no traffic to contend with or play tennis anytime I like.
The Bluffs, atop the hill on 4th Street near downtown Lafayette.
The Olympic Games are coming, and you can be part of them. Play McDonald's. When the U.S. wins, you win Olympic Games. Starting Thursday, July 12th.
Bob Hope was arrested in Little Rock, Arkansas this week. The charge, impersonating a comedian. Sheriff Tom Robinson explains the gag by saying the late Jack Benny had sworn out the warrant years ago. Robinson says the sheriff's department finally got around to issuing the warrant when Hope performed at the State House Convention Center in Little Rock.
What a guy. That's the late edition. Thanks for joining us. Good night.